Adam Savage here in my cave with a spotlight on a tool I've gotten some questions about lately, and it's specifically a measuring tool. Obviously, in any makerspace, measuring tools abound. There are tape measures, there are yardsticks, there are T-squares, there are combination squares like this beautiful old Starrett antique combination square that I love. And there are rulers like this one with inch markings that goes down to 16ths, and you can find them at even finer gradations. But what if you need to measure something that's way under a 32nd of an inch, or about 32,000ths of an inch? Well, in that case, you're going to need something with a much finer gradation than this. You're going to need calipers. And I have some very specific feelings about calipers, and that's why I wanted to talk to you about them today. This is my pair of dial calipers. These were actually made by Brown and Sharp. They're, I think, about 20 or 30 years old. And for years, let's see, where should I begin? I should begin at the beginning. My first set of calipers I bought looked like these. They were stainless steel, and I bought them at Fox Hardware on 4th and Mission back in 1992. They were $30, which was a lot of dough to me back then, but they lasted me for well over two decades. And the difference between what this can measure and what this can measure is pretty amazing. The first thing I did when I got it home is I looked at it and I thought, wow, that dial is, that's 100 gradations, and 10 of those is 1 inch. So it should be able to measure something really, really small. So wait a minute. And I pulled out one of my hairs, like this one here, and I decided to measure it with my calipers, and lo, I got a reading. Right, so when I put this without the hair in it, it goes right to the zero. And when I put it with the hair in it, it shows that my hair is about 1.5 thousandths thick. Your results may vary because my hair happens to be very fine. Thank you very much. The fact is, you can read something as thin as 1,000th of an inch thick on these things. You can measure sheets of paper and shims of metal, and it feels like a brand new superpower the first time you're running around your house measuring everything with this. Now, there are countless kinds of calipers to purchase, and I'd like to help you with that as well. Because for years, I used digital calipers like these Midutoyo calipers. And if you're gonna buy digital calipers, it's hard to do better than Midutoyo. They last forever, they have excellent battery life, and they're super accurate and super repeatable. And best of all, you can switch with a button, switch between inches and millimeters. That makes them very handy. But here in the cave, one of the things that bothers me is when batteries run out. So I have several digital calipers over there in my digital caliper holder, but their batteries are always dead because they sit there for months at a time without being used. This is a long way of explaining, this is the TLDR, is that I now use my dial calipers almost exclusively because, well, being able to read the gradations, how should I put this? There comes a moment in time as a carpenter when you start not just measuring to a mark, but you start measuring to the side of a mark. And that means, am I measuring to the middle of the mark, or to the right edge, or to the left edge? And those little bits of intuition about how carefully you're measuring something are part of every maker's progress in learning how big things should be and how to cut things to the proper size and give tolerances to the things that you're making. And for me, the dial caliper makes me a better machinist because this is what I have the intuition for. When I see the numbers, it certainly makes my calculator math easier, but it makes my intuition about my tolerances and the finesse of my machining less obvious. So, the dial calipers are what I go with. And you're in luck because the exact same, I think probably the same even manufacturer from 25 years ago that I bought from, sells these calipers on Amazon right now for like $20. That is a fantastic price drop from $1992. One of my favorite things in the shop, and it felt like one of those, it felt like progressing from adolescence to like young adulthood as a maker to buy my first set of calipers. I hope you feel the same way.